Welcome back. People are switching over from Kadamba to other means of transport, especially when it comes to travel outside the state. The count has fallen to 3 to 4 passengers per trip. This is adding to the loss to the Kadamba Transport Corporation that touches the figure of almost 16 crores a year. The trend has raised serious questions about the service to passengers by the KTC. Here is a report.
We are at the Margao bus stand at present. These are the Kadamba buses that ply on interstate routes. But ironically, the count of passengers have dropped miserably to 3 to 4 passengers. We spoke with one of the KTC driver on the Margao Manipal route.
Vasco, Sada Vasco, Manipal.
So, aki bus ada destination buses hui anna last.
Ata anchane first stop Pankon, Karwar, Ankola, Punta, Annavar, Bhatkar, Master Kundapur.
Basin na sada kitli passenger ra?
Saadhe akra timing asa, 11:30.
Passenger kitla?
11:30 timing.
Chala, passenger kitla asa?
3 passenger asa.
Whether it is 2 to 3 or a single passenger, the bus has to operate as per trip schedule. This is where Kadamba suffers major losses. This has been going on from past many years. Here, have a look at the annual loss suffered by the KTC during the last 3 years. 2008-2009, 15 crore 28 lakhs. 2009-2010, 14 crore 7 lakhs. 2010-2011, 15 crore 72 lakhs. The trend has raised serious questions about the service to passengers by the KTC. Even the CAG has on many occasions passed strictures on the government for mismanaging this lone state transport corporation. But the affairs haven't seen much improvement even with the change in the government. A reporter from Margao, Savio Dice.
Now, news from sports. One of India's all-time best football players, Bruno Coutinho, feels that the All India Football Federation needs to work in a professional manner. In recent times, clubs have been advised by the AFC and A.I.F.F. to follow professional criteria. But it seems that the A.I.F.F. itself is working in a haphazard manner. During the Federation Cup, Dempo Sports Club and Salgaonkar Football Club had to deal with poor grounds. Bruno says A.I.F.F. should have inspected the grounds before declaring the venues.
Many feel Bruno Coutinho's era saw better level of football than the present standard of football in India. Prudent caught up with Bruno to know his views on recent Federation Cup ground embarrassment.
It is up to the AIF. They should have first gone and at least inspect the ground. They think about professionalism in India where it is not up to the mark. Where they come, the AFC members come, they inspect the grounds and they say this is not good. So they should have think about the professional side and they should have gone and inspect the ground. Or not to lead it to somebody saying that this ground is not. If Tempos are complaining, if Chachil, if East Bengal is complaining, if Aeros are complaining, then there was something wrong with the grounds.
You feel with this backdrop, it's right that India are going to bid for the Under-17 FIFA World Cup. First of all, our local tournaments, our national local tournaments are not being organized well. You think it's the right thing that India could bid for the Under-17 World Cup and these basic facilities are not right?
You see, as for me, you know, for Under-17 World Cup, it can be built because in Goa, like the ground is going to be renovated. Renovation will be done about the ground, but in Delhi there is a beautiful ground. But if you go to different in now at present in Bombay, the corporate ground is coming. I think so. The beautiful ground is coming. So let's if these places are there, then we can bid for the ground. But as for me, AFF should go more professional. Where they want to go professional, they should go more professional in seeing the venues first where they want to organize it.
Bruno is a qualified beach football official but does not get many opportunities with the Indian team due to a lack of events. Again, the AIFF is failing to cash in on Goa's potential to become a beach football hub.
Even in beach soccer, we cannot do anything in Goa. It should come from AIFF. the people from the beach soccer worldwide think about doing something in beach soccer. But if A.I.F.F. doesn't want to do then anything, then it's not possible even for GFA or even for other association to do anything. Because beach soccer worldwide has to contact A.I.F.F. and A.I.F.F. in turn has to say that we want to fill the team.
Our sports reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Prajot Pednekar.
Nachiket Joshi from Pune won the All India Cycle Race organized by Dumrin Social, Cultural and Sports Club on Tuesday. Joel Fernandez of Chogale College finished second, while Fredson Marshall came third. The race was held from Vasco to Verna and back, covering 25 kilometers.
The race started from near MMC building in Vasco with a high number of cyclists taking part. Here are some highlights. Nachiket from Life Cycle Club of Pune praised the organizers.
Experience of racing in Goa was amazing. I had a blast of a race. It was really well organized and congratulations to the organizers. Very well organized, very well done, and I really wish to come here again and again every year.
Runner-up Joel Fernandez was content with his performance.
I could not start properly. I started a bit slower. I was still trying to catch up with the leader.
He did.
Then my bottle fell down, which I usually take my energy drink with. So I was literally without electrolytes the whole race.
Our reporter from Vasco, Surendra Madkekar.
If you have missed our bulletin, log on to www.prudentmedia.in or follow us on Twitter at Prudent Goa or meet us on Facebook at www.facebook.com/prudentmedia. And with this, we come to an end of this news bulletin. Keep watching Prudent Media.